Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Dr. John Scala.
We're going to start you off here with some video of the terrible destruction in Henryville, Indiana. Tornado moved through this location a few minutes after 3 p.m. this afternoon, about 20 miles north of Louisville, just over the river into Indiana. And you can see the immense destruction here. Yeah, those are school buses that were rolled by this tornado. The damage here will be investigated tomorrow, but from what I've seen, we're probably looking at wind speeds maybe on the order of 175 miles per hour with this event. Just a destructive day across the Tennessee Valley and into the Midwest. For us, though, we're dealing with temperatures and conditions that are much more sublime. And fortunately, we are not concerned about severe weather here. In fact, we're just looking at some rain showers across the region. There was some thunder a little bit a while ago moving right across Thomasville and also into the state capital. This hour, though, it's 42 degrees. Pretty much what you're seeing right here is about what we're going to see for the overnight lows. These temperatures are going to probably climb a few degrees by the time we reach tomorrow morning. This is a three-hour loop of the radar, and you can see what's happened. There was a very impressive line of storms several hours ago. There we go. That moved across and has basically collapsed and died. It's moved into the more stable air. Down to the south, you still can see some rain showers and perhaps one or two rumbles of thunder. But for the most part, that weather is basically done for us. But as Janelle was just saying to me, look at how this stretches from Pennsylvania all the way down into the deep south. We still have tornado warning watches in place, and they extend from western North Carolina, eastern Tennessee, down into the city of Atlanta and into Alabama and Mississippi. But fortunately, the trends are at this hour to diminish in strength. But what a day this has been across the Tennessee Valley. So cloudy with some rain showers around. Look for those temperatures in the lower 40s begin to make a climb as we head towards tomorrow morning. And as we start your day tomorrow, look for some sunshine maybe by mid-morning with temperatures climbing rapidly on the backside of this front. Winds will be gusty during the afternoon, 15 to 20. We could see some wind gusts of 35 miles per hour, but a mild day up into the mid-50s. As we take a look at how we did today, 50 degrees was the high temperature, typically 45 and 29. And we'll have to update the rainfall here. Obviously, we've had a little bit more rain in Harrisburg, probably more like a tenth of an inch or so just in the last hour. So taking you back, there is a dry slot in the mid-levels of the atmosphere, which is cutting across the Midwest and up towards the Great Lakes. And on the southern and eastern flank of those strong winds aloft is where the severe weather has occurred. And at this hour, it's coalesced more into a line of storms. We are still on the north side of this boundary, which will be continuing to work its way through during the overnight hours. And I think about 7 o'clock or so is when the front comes through. We'll see some rapid clearing and also some wind on the backside of that front. That front will be moving well off towards the east. Clearing skies Saturday night, but look what comes in on Sunday. The backside is another cold front, and that will be a reinforcing shot that could bring us some flurries, in fact, as we head into Sunday. So from a mild afternoon on Saturday, the temperatures really begin to fall out, heading down towards about 39 on Monday. And as we look at the upcoming work week, look at that. There's another rebound in place, and our temperatures come back towards 60.
John, quickly, this is an unusual time of year for tornadoes as well, isn't it?
We do expect severe weather to really begin to increase in March.
As it warms up, but I guess because it's already warm.
It's very very warm down there and moist, but it's these winds aloft which are so unusual.
All right. Thank you, John. Mm-hmm. Such a shame.